Okay, so this is the latest map that was added to DBD, Greenville Square, part of the Withered Isle realm. And some of you might have noticed a strange tile that can sometimes spawn on this map. As you can see, this structure features two pallets right next to each other. Now, there are a couple of variations of this tile, and sometimes it is able to generate more than once on the same map. In my opinion, this structure offers pretty interesting gameplay, and it is by far definitely not as overpowered as some people in the community think it is, since the overall length of this loop is pretty small, and the short sides are literally just a tree, sometimes not even having a rock. But did you know that during the early days of Dead by Daylight, these kinds of structures were literally all over the place, and pretty much every single map back then featured at least one loop like this. These tiles were nicknamed Double Pallets by the community, and they were actually a conscious design decision by the developers. Now, you know how today most filler tiles have two so-called spawn locations for pallets, and the pallet usually chooses only one of them to spawn at, right? Well, back in 2016 and 2017, this mechanic hadn't been implemented in the game yet, which meant that all filler tiles and other structures would generate pallets on all possible spawn locations. And this also extended to window vaults as well. For example, originally all jungle gyms featured two pallets and two windows simultaneously. Thankfully though, over time, most remnants of this mechanic were slowly but surely removed from the game, and for the longest time, any double pallet spawns would be caused purely by bugs and glitches, which would get fixed in pretty much no time. However, it looks as if the developers are experimenting with double pallets once again, and this time I think they're giving it a pretty good shot, since once again, this style is definitely not as bad as the ones from DBD's past, and in my opinion it offers pretty decent counterplay for both the killers and the survivor side. Let me know what you think about this style down in the comments. Another mechanic from DBD's past that returned is the 7 Blink Nurse. Now, as some of you might already know, when the nurse was first released to the public on the 18th of August 2016, she had not two but three blinks by default. Furthermore, most of her add-ons also had completely different effects compared to how they currently function. For instance, the original Campbell's Last Breath slightly decreased the maximum blinking range, however in return it gave you two whole additional chain blinks. Another add-on by the name of Fragile Whiz also had this function, although it had a little bit more downsides in comparison to the other one. And so by pairing these two add-ons together, you could get a nurse with 7 whole entire available blink charges. Thankfully, however, only a little bit more than a month after the release of the Last Breath chapter, the 1.1.2 update introduced some much needed balance changes to this character. These included making the nurse vulnerable to light burning, as well as decreasing her default movement speed from 4 to 3.85 meters per second. Among these changes was also a nerf to the green Fragile Whiz add-on, which made it only provide one additional chain blink instead of the previous two, and the character as a whole was also made to only have two available blink charges by default. All of these changes together made it so that the nurse was able to have a maximum of 5 blinks at once. However, this would all change once again with patch 3.3.0, when the character was given a big overhaul which pretty much resembled a rework. That update made the nurse only able to have a total of 3 blinks max, which could only happen by using one of her new iridescent add-ons, the Torn Bookmark. And that is how this killer stayed for a pretty decent chunk of the game's history, up until the start of 2023. 2023's first developer update included yet another long-awaited balance rework to the nurse. However, the developers probably didn't take something pretty significant into account. Now, the nurse has a purple add-on called Jenner's Last Breath. Currently, it allows the nurse to blink back to her original location after all blinks have been exhausted, restoring exactly one blink charge in the process. However, during the 6.5.0 PTB, this add-on would return all of the nurse's blinks upon use. This meant that if you selected the Torn Bookmark as your other add-on, Jenner's Last Breath would restore 3 whole entire blink charges. So effectively, if you used all of your first 3 available blinks, then utilized Jenner's Last Breath, and then another 3 blinks, this resulted in you being able to teleport a total of 7 whole times in a single blink chain. The only downside to this was that, since the fatigue duration is determined by the total count of blinks used, the cooldown after that would be honestly pretty lengthy. However, for the live release of the 6.5.0 update, Jenner's Last Breath was changed to how it is today, and so the nurse can only blink a maximum of 5 times. Alright, now let's move on to the next part of the video. When Mount Ormond Resort was first released in Dead by Daylight, it featured this orange snow cat tile, which pretty closely resembles the one that we currently have in the game. It has a very safe palette that could be looped with ease, however there was one big difference between the two versions of the structure. As you can see, the old one had a little staircase which led to the cabin of the snow cat, where you were able to access and fast vault this window. So basically, in a way, this was a lot like the crane from Autohaven Wreckers, which we still have in the game to this very day. With the exception that the one in Ormond had climbable, like, tires? I'm not sure what these are called, but you were able to proc balance landing off of them. Strangely enough, however, shortly after the map's release, this structure was completely removed from it without any kind of explanation on the developer's part. And since the original Ormond was known to cause crashes pretty regularly, this led people to believe that the snow cat was the tile that was causing them, and that this was the reason for its removal. However, we'll probably never know the real story behind this structure's removal. But when Ormond was given a complete visual overhaul as part of the Realm Beyond update during patch 4.4.0, the orange snow cat miraculously returned to the map, though not without a couple of changes. First of all, the inside of the vehicle was completely closed off, and so the only resource at this tile is the God Pallet that we all know today. In addition, players could no longer climb on top of the tires, and the tile was also rotated 180 degrees in relation to its original orientation. Yet another thing that was brought back fairly recently is Dwight's old lobby animation. This is a pretty minor addition compared to the other things that we've taken a look at so far, but basically when Dead by Daylight was first released back in the summer of 2016, all survivors used to have completely different idle animations while in the lobby, and to be fair, the characters looked a lot more nervous back then compared to today. Now, most of these animations were changed pretty early on, however it looks as if Bhvr has brought them back for DBD's latest PTB. And even though it is unclear if this is a bug or working as intended, I honestly can't believe that these animations still exist in the game almost 8 years later. Well, I guess that was it. We went through 4 things from DBD's past that returned. I know I'm kind of late to this, but I'm just now noticing that this channel has reached more than 1 million views total, and I really wanna thank you guys for all of the support, I truly appreciate it. Anyways, I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, then make sure to let me know by leaving a like down below, and also I would be glad if you would consider subscribing as well. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!